Good morning. Here is today's word of blessings for you. 1 Thessalonians 2:1-6. You know, brothers and sisters, that our visit to you was not without results. We had previously suffered and been treated outrageously in Philippi, as you know, but with the help of our God we dared to tell you his gospel in the face of strong opposition. For the appeal we make does not spring from error or impure motives, nor are we trying to trick you. On the contrary, we speak as those approved by God to be entrusted with the gospel. We are not trying to please people but God, who tests our hearts. You know we never used flattery, nor did we put on a mask to cover up greed, God is our witness. We were not looking for praise from people, not from you or anyone else, even though as apostles of Christ we could have asserted our authority. Today's title is approved by God. One of the most frequent temptations for the servants of God is to please man instead of God. God's servants all know enough that they should not do that. But the temptation sometimes becomes so strong that it is not easy to resist. Preachers are constantly facing such temptations. They all know that their message is supposed to be focused on God and glorify God. But they cannot see God. On the contrary, they see the people before him. They want to get positive responses from the people. So, they try to please the people instead of God, consciously or unconsciously. Some of the preachers even justify such man-centered preaching. But true servants of God can never do that. They have a clear focus on God and never compromise with the temptation to please the people instead of God. Apostle Paul was clearly one of such God-centered servants of God. He refused to compromise it resolutely. As we have already said, so now I say again, if anybody is preaching to you a gospel other than what you accepted, let them be under God's curse. Am I now trying to win the approval of human beings, or of God? Or am I trying to please people? If I were still trying to please people, I would not be a servant of Christ. Galatians 1:9-10. Such a God-centered message may not always get a positive response from the people. Preachers can have strong opposition or persecution for that. That's what happened to Paul and Silas when they preached the gospel in Philippi. But they didn't yield to it. You know, brothers and sisters, that our visit to you was not without results. We had previously suffered and been treated outrageously in Philippi, as you know, but with the help of our God we dared to tell you his gospel in the face of strong opposition. But a man-pleasing message would never save the souls of man. Only a God-centered message that is true to the Bible will save the souls with the help of God. That was what Paul and did in Thessalonica. By the grace of God, Thessalonians accepted the pure gospel wholeheartedly. On the contrary, we speak as those approved by God to be entrusted with the gospel. We are not trying to please people but God, who tests our hearts. You know we never used flattery, nor did we put on a mask to cover up greed, God is our witness. This spiritual principle is not only true for preaching but also for all other works of believers. Our work should be approved by God whether it is approved by man or not. Only work that's approved by God will have a lasting impact. All Christians should work diligently. We are never to be lazy. At the same time, we should always ask whether our work is God-centered or man-centered. How hard do you work? What is your work centered on? God or man?